Today, we will discuss the lesson number 1 from module 1 titled Environment through Aegis of Environmental Science, Senior Secondary Course. Title of the lesson is Origin of Earth and Evolution of Environment. I am Neelam Gupta, your course coordinator. Welcome you in this program. We live on a beautiful planet called Earth. Questions about the origin of life on Earth has often occurred in our minds. In order to know the evolutionary history of life on Earth, we must first know about the origin and development of the planet Earth. Our Earth is a part of a vast universe. The universe is about 15 to 20 billion years old. The age of the Earth is approximately 4 to 5 billion years. During this program, you shall learn how the Earth originated, how it got its own environment, and in what ways human beings have been using the environmental resources for their welfare and development. Objective of this program is to trace the origin of the Earth, to list the conditions which made Earth a unique planet for supporting life, to describe the sequence of steps in the origin and evolution of life, next to explain the term environment, and the last one is to enumerate the biotic and abiotic component of the environment. Do you know that the primitive people could accurately know the position and movement of the sun, moon and stars, and their survival depended on their ability to read the calendars in the sky? But the universe for the primitive man was restricted to a small piece of land that included rivers, seas, the hills, the sky, the sun giving lights and warmth, and the moon that appeared in the night. However, outside this little universe of their lives, an unimagined mystery, a great revolution in human thought began when philosophers tried to understand universe, observe the world around them. Why did the moon change its shape? Why did a few stars, now we know that our planets, moved among the others? In fact, sun is also a star. The Earth, with all its diversity, along with the other planets and their satellites, the sun, asteroids and comets that move around the sun, and the moon forms the universe. Here, I would also like to tell you that sun in the middle, with a number of planets orbiting around it, constitute the solar system. Our universe is a large but unimaginable expanse of dust, clouds, gas, stars, galaxies and life. Now you look at the picture about solar system. The next topic of this lesson is Earth as a part of the universe. Our Earth, with all its diversity, along with other planets and their satellites, the sun, the moon, and the many galaxies forms the universe. Space between galaxies, matter and energy also form a part of the universe. This is an overall picture of our solar system. Man has always been eager to know about Earth and its vast rich biodiversity. Earth, our home, is the third planet from the sun. It is the fifth largest of the planet in the solar system, smaller than the four gas giants, that is Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune, but larger than the three other rocky planets, that is Mercury, Mars and Venus. This is a picture of origin of Earth. Scientists believe that about 100 billion years ago, the Earth, the Sun and all the planets of the solar system were nothing but a cloud of cold dust particles swirling through empty space. Gradually, these particles were attracted to each other and came together to form a huge spinning disk. This is a total figure of planets around the sun. 4 or 5 billion years ago, they turned into the planets that we know today as Earth, Mars, Venus, Neptune, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Mercury. Finally, the Earth cooled down, the ball of gas slowed down from spinning, and the color changed from white to yellow to red to not giving off any light at all. The Earth contracted, getting smaller, and the gas changed to liquid as they cooled. Heavier materials drew to the center of the earth. The heavier liquid settled at the middle of the earth. As the earth cooled more, a solid crust formed over the liquid material. As the crust cooled, it got wrinkled and burst open in spots. Gradually, cracks formed in the crust. The part of the earth we live on is a very thin layer relative to the inner earth. The innermost layer is the core of the earth. It has two parts, the inner core and the outer core. The inner core is very hot and made of heavy metals, mostly iron. Do you know that this core of the earth is so hot that it can roast a human body also? The next layer is the mantle. It is made up of a hard rock which is heavier than the earth's rock. The layer that we live on is called the crust. It is thickest under the continents and thinner under the oceans. The crust is actually not as solid as it feels to us and shifts sometimes abruptly during earthquakes and very slowly as when continents drift. This figure shows the overall components are found on the earth. Scientists have been exploring the other planets and have found that a few planets have atmosphere, ice and even oceans. But it is only the earth that is known to have an atmosphere containing free oxygen, oceans of liquid water on its surface and has the right combination of these to sustain life. Now we will discuss about conditions necessary for sustaining life on earth. This is a figure of earth. Life originated in water. 2/3 of living organisms consist of water. 90% of the cell content of living organism is water. Biochemical reactions in living organisms require water. That we'll discuss later during this program. First condition which is necessary to sustain life on earth is presence of water. The rain at first evaporated as soon as it hit the earth. Later, as the earth continued to cool, the rain stayed on to form lakes and oceans. At first, the water was all fresh water, but as it had chemicals from the earth's crust mix in, the water of the oceans became salty. At one time, the earth was all water on its surface. Earth's ocean covered about 70% of the planet's surface. Fresh water exists in liquid form in lakes and rivers and as water vapor in the atmosphere, which causes much of Earth's weather. Next condition on life on Earth sustained as atmosphere. That is most important component on, in the atmosphere is oxygen, carbon dioxide, water vapor, etc. The present composition of the atmosphere is 21% oxygen, 78% nitrogen, 0.03% carbon dioxide, less than 0.9% argon and neon, etc. The atmosphere was not like this when the Earth was created over 4 to 5 billion years ago. In the first billion years, the Earth's surface was originally molten. The volcanoes gave out massive amount of carbon dioxide, steam, ammonia and methane. There was no oxygen. The steam condensed to form water, which then produced shallow seas. Evidences point to bacteria flourishing 3.8 billion years ago. So, this means that life came into existence about 700 million years after the Earth was created. Such early forms of life exist in the shallow oceans. In the next billion years, these primitive life forms then took the next evolutionary step and started to photosynthesize, that is using sunlight to convert carbon dioxide and water to food, energy and oxygen. This was an important turning point in Earth history because the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere was being converted to oxygen. These green plants went on producing oxygen and removing the carbon dioxide. Most of the carbon from the carbon dioxide in the air became locked up in sedimentary rocks as carbonates and fossil fuels. Carbon dioxide also dissolved into the oceans. The ammonia and methane in the atmosphere reacted with the oxygen. Nitrogen was also released partly from the reaction between ammonia and oxygen, but mainly from living organisms such as denitrifying bacteria. Remember that nitrogen is a very unreactive gas and it has built up slowly the last 2.5 billion years or so. Next condition on the earth for sustaining life is temperature. Average temperature of the earth is 16 degrees centigrade, which is the most comfortable temperature for living organisms to survive. The last condition for sustaining life on earth is buffering capacity. The most unique feature of the earth is its buffering action, due to which a neutral pH, that is pH 7, is maintained in the soil and water bodies. The neutral pH is congenial for the survival and sustenance of living organisms. Earth gets light from the sun. It is the ultimate source of energy. Now we come to the next section, is origin and evolution of life on earth, including human beings. As soon as the oxygen was produced by photosynthesis, it was taken out again by reacting with other elements. This continued until about 2.1 billion years ago, when the concentration of oxygen increased markedly. As oxygen levels built up in the atmosphere, it marked a trigger for the biological evolution to begin and progress. Protists developed from bacteria. Both protists and bacteria are unicellular organisms. From the protists came the multicellular organisms. Today, we have such a vast biodiversity that these organisms are grouped into 5 kingdoms, namely Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. Now we come to the component of the environment, that is biotic and abiotic. All the organisms live in close association with the environment and depend on it for their survival. Thus, we can say that environment is the surrounding in which the organisms lives. Our environment consists of 2 major components, that is biotic and abiotic. We all know that the earth, its blue sky, vast oceans and lush green forest and the land is the home to a wide variety of organisms. Now we are seeing a figure on the screen, that is component of the environment. Biotic components includes all living organisms, that is microbes, plants, animals, fungi, whereas abiotic components includes climate, atmospheric gases, water, light, etc. All living organisms are dependent on the abiotic component for their survival. Sunlight provides energy, which is utilized by the green plants to prepare their food by the process of photosynthesis. Heterotrophs depend on the plant for the survival. Microbes and fungi decompose the dead plants and animals, releasing the nutrients locked in the dead plants and animals back into the environment. We all know that it is impossible to survive without water. Water not only helps to regulate body temperature, but majority of the biochemical reactions in our body takes place in the presence of water. Water is also a home for many of the plants and animals. Temperature is a very important factor of the environment, as all living organisms can tolerate only a certain range of temperature. Thus, there is a very delicate balance between the biotic and abiotic component of the environment. Now, we will discuss about what is environment. Every living organism is constantly interacting with its environment. The environment may be defined as the surroundings or conditions in which an organism lives or operates, or we can say in other words, all the living organisms are constantly interacting with its environment. This is a picture of overall picture of biotic and abiotic components of the environment. The environment comprises of abiotic or non-living component like light, water, atmospheric gases, climate and substrata. And living or biotic component includes living organisms, that is plants, animals, microorganisms and human beings. This is all about lesson 1, origin of earth and evolution of the environment. Thank you.